on you in any way that this movie you made so many years ago is, you know, being shown like in
I'm thrilled it's being shown. Oh gosh. And you know, back to see it on the big screen again is going to be very exciting for me because it was my first movie and I was about 18. I'm 90 now, so.
Looking good for 90.
But I had a wonderful time and I'm thrilled to see it on the big screen. I think you'll love it. You know, the music itself holds up so well. Rodgers and Hammerstein. It's just
a great score.
A great score.
Yes, and great singers.
Yeah.
Including
Gordon McRae, Gene Nelson, you know.
The wonderful Charlotte Greenwood is in it.
Charlotte Greenwood, yes.
James Whitmore, a wonderful cast.
Wonderful cast of people.
Now, was that a traumatic thing for you auditioning for it? I know at one point, I think every woman of a certain age and every man in Hollywood, including James Dean, before he was even James Dean, auditioned for it.
Everybody did.
Everybody wanted to be in
it. You know, I was, the story was, you know, I was in New York and I was on my way to college to become a veterinarian. I didn't want to be in show business. I was going to be a vet and I went to an open audition for Rodgers and Hammerstein's casting director. And they just started auditioning people all over the country. You know, movie stars and then Broadway stars and everybody. But I was this little girl that I hadn't done a thing. I mean, I was, you know, high school was all I had for me. And I went and auditioned for the casting director and he in turn called Mr. Rodgers in to hear me personally and he called Oscar Hammerstein in to hear me personally. And that's how it all started.
And then you did a show for them, right?
Then I, 3 weeks later, I was in the chorus of South Pacific the last 3 months of the show. And after that, in the meantime, they screen tested every young woman in Hollywood for the role. And in New York, too. I mean, all over the place.
Now, were you aware of, were you show business wise enough to be aware of the competition and the fact that you probably didn't have a chance to do it?
Robert, I didn't even think I had a chance to do anything at that point. You know, I was going to go and take care of animals someplace. And
they're testing everybody. I
had no idea I was going to.
So how did they tell you that you?
I went into South Pacific and I was playing one of the nurses and I had a little acting role, which was nice. And the thing about me is I was always able to sing. It was a gift. I was the youngest member of the church choir at age 6. You know, so it was a gift that was given to me. And that I thought everybody could do. I thought everybody sang. I mean, and when they heard me sing, they got very excited about the way I sang, I guess. But as I said, in the meantime, I did 2 shows for them, one on the road and one on Broadway. And while I was doing them, as I said, they screen tested everybody. Finally, Richard Rodgers called me and he said, "We're sending you to California to screen test for the Rolling Lord in the movie of Oklahoma." I said, "You're kidding, really? I'm going to screen test." And as a matter of fact, Shirley MacLaine and I were in a show together on Broadway. That's where we first met. And she found out I was going to screen test for the role of Laurie. She said, listen, you've got to do something for me. You've got to get me 8-0 Annie. You've got to get me 8-0 Annie. I said, Shirley, I'm not casting this.